In this video, I'm going to demonstrate using an if-elif-else statement to choose exactly one of several alternatives by creating a program that computes the amount of Canadian federal income tax payable without considering any tax deductions. Federal income tax is a progressive tax, meaning that the tax rate progresses from low to high as income increases. In 2016, the tax rates vary from 15% on income up to approximately $45,000, all the way up to 33% on earnings beyond $200,000. I'll begin by writing a comment that describes the purpose of my program and a few comments that briefly outline the steps that I'll take to create it. My first Python statements create variables to hold the tax rates and tax bracket limits. Doing this ensures that each of the numeric values only appears in my program once, which will make it easier to update when the tax brackets and tax rates change in the future. I'll continue by writing the code for reading the income from the user. It's converted to a floating point number by calling the float function. I'll use an if-elif-else statement to identify the tax bracket for the income entered by the user. Each of the bodies will compute the amount of tax payable on the income. I'll start with the lowest tax bracket. In this case, all of the income is taxed at the lowest rate, so I only need to multiply the income by the lowest tax rate to compute the tax payable. The next tax bracket will be tested with an elif statement. Notice that its condition only checks that the income is less than the limit for the second tax bracket. It isn't necessary to verify that the income is greater than or equal to the limit for the first tax bracket, because the body of the if statement will run in that situation, which will cause the body of the elif to be skipped without evaluating its condition. The body of this elif statement is a little bit more complicated than the body of the if statement, because the portion of the income that is in the first tax bracket is taxed at a lower rate than the portion of the income that is in the second tax bracket. I'll add additional elif statements to take care of the third and fourth tax brackets. Each condition verifies the income is less than the limit for the tax bracket. Each body computes the amount of tax payable. The bodies are longer for the higher tax brackets because there are more brackets of income, each of which are taxed at different rates. Finally, I'll complete the if-elif-else statement by adding an else case to compute the tax for incomes of at least $200,000. I'll complete the program by adding a print statement that displays the income and the tax payable. I have formatted both of the values so that they always include exactly two decimal places. Let's see what happens when we run the program. When the user enters an income in the first tax bracket, the condition on the if statement evaluates to true, so Python runs the body of the if statement and computes the amount of tax payable. Since the body of the if statement was run, Python skips all of the elif and else bodies and goes on and displays the result. This time, we'll run the program with an income that is in the third tax bracket. After the value is read, Python evaluates the condition on the if statement. It evaluates to false, so Python skips the body of the if statement and goes on and considers the condition on the first elif statement. The condition on the first elif statement is also false, so Python skips its body and considers the condition on the second elif statement. It evaluates to true, so Python runs the body of the second elif statement and computes the amount of tax. Then Python skips the bodies of the remaining elif and else statements and goes on and displays the result. This program has demonstrated using an if-elif-else statement to choose exactly one of several alternatives. I hope that watching this video has increased your understanding of this topic.